a really full social life, so that was nice. My husband teases me that I never got out of the house until I ran for Woman of the Year.
Not only was it the fundraising, but it was the fact that I was trying to get people to join the Be the Match registry.
I think meeting this goofball, to be completely honest with you, she keeps me up to date on apps like Snapchat and stuff like that, what the kids are saying.
It gives people a way to get involved in something bigger than themselves. We all want to do things. We all say, I want to get involved. I want to do something. But this gives you a real opportunity to do it.
Everyone's been touched by cancer, and LLS in particular fights blood cancers, but that helps extend to other cancers. They help improve the quality of life for patients and their families, and that's a great way to help with that particular cause, and it is a lot of fun. As you can tell, I like to have fun.
When Elizabeth and Carolyn Goldstein took me out to lunch and sort of, you know, dropped this on my lap, and it took me a couple of days to think about it, but I said, why not? You know, it's just fundraising for a wonderful cause, and if people want to help, they will, and there's so many charitable people here in Southern New England that I figured I'd try to use what little, you know, influence I had and go for it and see what I could do.
I think the camaraderie of with all the other candidates was fun. You get to have a little bit of banter back and forth, and you meet some good friends and some good people, and you're raising money for a great charity.
Fulfilling is, I guess, is the word that I always come back to, and you know, gratitude. It's, you know, I'm grateful for the people that run and do it every year, and I got a good sense of accomplishment over, you know, just finding out from friends of mine, hey, you know, didn't know you were involved in this. It's great because my aunt or my brother, or unfortunately, it seems like everybody has a tie to blood cancer. So
we had this huge event at the Tennis Hall of Fame, and Haley couldn't go because she was actually too sick to show up. So that was probably in our third or fourth week, and that just, I mean, talking to her all the time and being with her, obviously, like, you just wouldn't know that she was sick. But then when she couldn't show up to that event, I was like, we're gonna raise as much money as we can. I got mad about it. I said, you know what, cancer? Kiss my, you know. And I said, we're gonna raise as much money as we can. So she really motivated me. And as I said before, I'm very competitive. So it's like, I don't want anyone to beat me.
To me, the meaning of life is to be of service. Very simple. It doesn't take any great scientists or theologians to figure it out. It's just to be of service, to help other people. And by being in this campaign and this program, you never know when that next dollar or that dollar, extra dollar you brought in may be the one that touches a research person or a clinician or a doctor or a nurse.
Everyone wins when cancer loses.
Everyone wins when cancer loses.
Everyone wins when cancer loses.
Everybody wins when cancer loses.
Everyone 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 wins when cancer loses. Hoo-yah!
Everyone wins when cancer loses.
Everybody wins when cancer loses.
I think I like to say that I got more out of it than I was able to bring, and it really just helped me and helped my family keep us a little bit more centered. And
people are very generous when you present the right case study to them.
People tend to be more generous after a couple drinks.